iPhone security vulnerabilities are more common than you think. Earlier this year, there was a major security flaw with iOS 16.3 that allowed malicious web pages to run code on your iPhone.
In this video, we're going to tell you about every iPhone security setting you need to change to keep your phone and your data safe, not just in this life, but into the next.
Well, I'm dead.
Let's open the Settings app and tap on your Apple ID at the top of the screen. Then tap Password and Security, and take a look at two-factor authentication.
With two-factor authentication, when you sign in with your Apple ID for the first time on a new device, you don't just enter your password, you also then have to enter a 6-digit verification code or use a security key, which we'll talk about in a minute.
If it was just one-factor authentication, you just enter your password and you'd be in, that's much less secure than two-factor authentication.
And thank God there isn't three-factor authentication, because then nobody would be able to access any of their accounts.
Not yet, anyway. Right now, two-factor is on for me and I can't do anything. That's because when you turn on two-factor authentication on your iPhone, you only have 2 weeks to change your mind before it's on forever.
If two-factor is off for you, just tap continue and follow the on-screen prompts.
Next, we're gonna talk about advanced data protection. Tap back upper left-hand corner of the screen, then tap on iCloud, scroll down, and tap Advanced Data Protection.
This is a new feature in iOS 16.2. I like it personally. Let's talk about how it works.
Advanced Data Protection uses end-to-end encryption to ensure that the iCloud data types listed here can only be decrypted on your trusted devices, protecting your information in the case that the cloud gets breached.
The interesting thing here is that Apple is definitely admitting that iCloud could be breached. Any cloud platform could be hacked. But Apple is protecting you and themselves by doing this.
End-to-end encryption is a security measure that ensures that only the sender and the intended recipient can read the message or the data being sent.
If somebody just hacks Apple's servers, they get a bunch of gobbledygook that they can't access.
Yeah, I think gobbledygook is the technical term Apple uses. To turn on advanced data protection, just tap Turn on Advanced Data Protection. You'll be responsible for your data recovery. We'll review our recovery methods. I have a recovery contact as my wife. Tap Continue. Enter your iPhone passcode. And then it'll say Advanced Data Protection is on. Tap Done.
Bear in mind that when you turn this on, you may also have to update your iPad, Mac, and other Apple devices so that they're running software versions that are also compatible with advanced data protection.
And while we're talking about your other devices, let's talk about your trusted devices. So if we go on our iPhone, back to iCloud, back to Apple ID, come down to this list. These are the devices attached to your Apple ID. So if I tap on David's MacBook, for instance, you'll know it's a trusted device because it'll say this device is trusted and can receive Apple ID verification codes.
Trusted devices are important because you need one to be around when you log into a new device for the first time with your Apple ID, because that's where the code is going to pop up.
Here's a security tip. Don't trust devices you don't control.
For example, if David had sold this MacBook and it was still a trusted device for him, he would want to go in here and remove it.
All I would need to do is tap remove from account to get rid of this trusted device.
In our video about secret iPhone developer settings, we talk about how to clear the trusted devices from your iPhone, which is a little bit different, but it's an interesting watch. You can check out that video in the card above and in the link in the description below.
Do you trust us? I sure hope so. If you do, click that subscribe button below this video. We won't let you down.
Next, let's talk about account recovery contacts.
Let's tap back to our Apple ID settings, upper left-hand corner of the screen. Scroll up and tap Password and Security. Then scroll down to Account Recovery and tap on that.
A recovery contact is someone who can help you recover your data if you forget your iCloud password or device passcode. Make sure that this is someone you trust.
Let's add a recovery contact. I'll tap Add Recovery Contact. First thing Apple says, add someone you trust. Really reinforce that point. Let's tap Add Recovery Contact. I have to Face ID to get in. I'll choose David Payette.
It's me.
I'll tap Add.
He trusts me.
Trust you enough to do this for a demo and a video, yeah. On your iPhone, you'll be prompted to send that person a message. I recommend just sticking with Apple's default message. Tap Send, and then tap Done. On David's phone, he's gonna receive a notification because Apple doesn't let you just add recovery contacts willy-nilly. The person who you're trying to add also needs to confirm this.
I just got a message from David. It says, I'd like to add you as my recovery contact. Well, I'll tap on this to accept, and then tap accept again, and now I have been added as David's recovery contact.
Now on my iPhone it says pending, but if I tap on David Payette, it'll say that he is a recovery contact. Now, maybe you lose trust in that person, and you don't want them to be your recovery contact anymore.
Me?
You just come in here and tap remove contact and then tap remove contact. You have to enter your Apple ID password.
I'm just hacking David's data. Yeah. This is my last chance.
You've had 15 seconds to hack my data, so. Bummer.
Missed out again.
Recovery, contact removed, just tap done.
Next, let's talk about legacy contacts. This is someone who will be able to access your data if you die.
I'm definitely dead.
Let's tap back, upper left-hand corner of the screen. One below, account recovery is legacy contact. Tap on that. Pretty similar process here. You would just tap add legacy contact.
So you trust your wife for the account recovery, but yeah. Not if you die.
Not apparently not.
No.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Let's tap add legacy contact again. Face ID to get in here. Then select your contact. Here's where things get a little tricky. So if I select David Payette, there's no real clear option here. If you just tap message, it'll say access your digital legacy, tap continue, show your access key, send access key in the messages app. I'll tap on that. Again, stick with Apple's default message and tap send. And legacy contact added has been shared with David Payette.
David's old and gray. His grandkids get into his phone and they say, I didn't know Grandpa took pictures of that.
Yeah, they'll be like, wow, there's a lot of screenshots and screen recordings in here. Look how phones used to look.
Grandpa was boring.
Now again, maybe you lose trust in this person. You say, you know what? I don't want them to be able to see all of my photos and data after I die. Just come back in here to legacy contacts, tap on that person, and then tap remove contact, remove contact.
David and I were talking about, when do you ask someone to become your recovery contact? Is it before you propose or after? Is it after you're married?
I think it's engagement, account recovery contact, marriage, legacy contact.
Okay.
Unless you don't really trust that person, you sign into your prenup, you know, this person can never be a legacy contact after we get married.
You don't want to overshoot the mark here. If you're dating someone, you don't want to just make them your account recovery contact. Mm. You're going to look desperate.
Yeah, it'd be a good icebreaker first date.
Yeah.
I don't have a legacy contact. Nobody can save my digital legacy.
Yeah. That'd be good. Now that we've cleared that up, let's talk about the importance of keeping your iPhone up to date.
We mentioned earlier how iOS updates sometimes have major security flaws. That's why it's a good idea to always keep your iPhone up to date. Let's tap back to the main page of settings, upper left-hand corner of the screen. Scroll down, tap general, tap software update, and if an update is available, tap download and install.
And there's a new switch inside automatic updates that's just as important.
Let's tap on automatic updates. Make sure the switch next to security responses and system files is on.
In the event of hackageddon, Apple will be able to push a security response to your phone so you don't get hacked, hopefully.
While your iPhone is updating, we want to tell you about some of our new channel members. We've got G, short and sweet, like that. Chris Shaw, Catherine Sink, Mom to Max and Angie, a little two for the price of one shout out there. Economical. And Johnny Murray. They click that join button below this video. They got member shout outs, PDFs for some of our videos, and a whole lot more. Click the join button below this video, see what you can get.
I think it's a three for one, David, because you got Mom, you got Max, and you got Angie.
There you go, three for one. Now that your iPhone is up to date, we need to talk about security keys. Let's head back to the main page of settings. Scroll up and tap on your Apple ID at the top of the screen. Tap password and security, then tap security keys.
What are security keys? They replace two-step verification codes. Now, all you need to do is enter your passcode and then tap the security key to the top of your phone.
Let's tap add security key. This is a feature for iPhones running iOS 16.3 or newer. Get your security key if it has NFC, near field communication.
Wow.
Hold it up to the top of the screen. I gotta enter my passcode first, oh boy. Looking like a fool in this video. And now we can add our security key, hold it right to the top of your phone. Easy. Too easy. Tap done, upper right-hand corner of the screen. But security keys are not as simple as I just made it look, and some security keys are better than others. Check out our next video to learn everything you need to know about security keys, as well as which security keys to actually buy. We'll see you there.